we are now approaching mid-June, so I do apologize for that sort of hiatus. Just to be completely honest, and I'm definitely not trying to, you know, make excuses or anything like that, but I have really this year been in the darkest place mentally that I've ever been in my life. And it's just been a really rough time. Like, I have been so severely depressed pretty much since the winter. And, you know, it just got to the point where I wasn't even really able to get up out of bed. I was sleeping all day, sleeping all day, sleeping all day, sleeping all day, sleeping all day. Not to be TMI, but not even really showering or taking care of myself that much. I was just so consumed with the depression.
Honest about it. I mean, regardless of what people are gonna think, I'm not gonna lie.
on Social Security knows that it's something, but it's not enough, especially in this economy. So I've just been trying to put something into savings. Like, obviously, I still have to live at home, and my parents do help with a lot just because of the fact that, like, Social Security does not cover much. You know, I take care of what I can. It does really suck because I want to be able to be independent and, you know, have my own place and all that, but health-wise, that's just not realistic at this point, and financially, also not realistic. But I've just been trying to make money on the side just so that way it's there, and, you know, I can put it into savings for whatever. And I actually did really well the first month that I was selling on Depop. I made like probably 5 or 6 or 7, I think like 7 sales in less than 2 weeks of joining Depop. So that was pretty awesome because, like, I no more joined Depop and I was making sales. But after I made those sales, like, things kind of slowed down and I haven't really made any sales, like, at all. I did not make barely any sales last month. And so far this month, I have not made any sales either. I might have made one sale. I don't remember. I might have made one sale, but I'm not sure. I'm not 100% sure. But, you know, when you resell things, like, it really does vary, you know? Like, it's not just going to be, you're not going to be getting sales coming in all the time unless you are literally, like, you know, some content creators on TikTok, like, that's kind of their careers, like, they're Depop and they're reselling, and they're able to make a lot of income from that because that's their whole brand, and, you know, they make outfit videos and, you know, all of that. But, like, I would love to be able to make, like, fashion videos on TikTok and stuff like that, but it's not as easy to, like, be able to make an income off of that or to get more views and more sales on your Depop just from promoting it on TikTok, you know? Like, it's not as easy as it seems. Literally, I think a lot of influencers are kind of, like, tone deaf is not the word, but it's like they don't realize that sometimes it doesn't really matter how much hard work you put in, the algorithm either picks it up or it doesn't, you know what I mean? Like, this advice that people give, basically, that if you are not succeeding at getting a certain amount of followers or, you know, things aren't picking up, it's because you're not working hard enough or you're not putting the effort into your content. And it's like, that's a really problematic viewpoint, in my opinion, because that's basically like saying, well, the people who are famous for it or the people who are making an income from their TikTok videos or whatever, they, you know, they only are successful because they've put in the work. Some people don't even try and they blow up, you know? We live in an unfair world. It's not always about hard work. And I don't know if that's an unpopular opinion or not. And I don't mean that to be discouraging to anyone. I think that people can do anything they set their mind to. But I do think that it is discouraging advice to tell people that if they are not succeeding at something, that they're not trying hard enough. Because it's like, why are you assuming that they're not trying as hard as the people who have been successful? Like, why is that your first thought? So, yeah. And also, I don't really, like, I've never been someone that wants to make content for money. There's nothing wrong with wanting to make content for money. But for me, I'd rather be able to help people in some sort of way with something that they're struggling with. I'd rather know that I'm making a difference in someone's life than to have money, you know what I mean? Like, it's more meaningful to me to be able to make a difference than it is to have money. And I know that probably sounds corny and cheap, but I mean, it's true so many times throughout my life, and even now, like, I just feel so alone at times, especially with being a young adult and not might not have one, you know what I mean? Because that's essentially, not that I don't have a safe space, because I do, my family is amazing, but ASMR has still been a safe space for me in many ways, and it has made such a tremendous difference in my life. And, you know, my family has always been so supportive of me wanting to do ASMR, and they were really happy when I discovered ASMR myself, because I had struggled, I still do struggle with insomnia, but I never really had anything that helped me relax before, and when I discovered ASMR, I was finally able to relax, you know, so, but yeah, and I know some people, like I said, some people don't have a support system at all, some people don't have a safe space at all, and that's why I think the ASMR community is so great and so important, because, you know, you're able to essentially, like, give someone a safe space. That should be the goal, in my opinion, you know, like, to be a safe space for someone who is struggling, who needs comfort, who needs to relax, all of that, you know, that's really what ASMR is about. I don't think that ASMR is something that people should get into for money. I just don't think it's that type of content. There is types of content where it definitely makes sense for it to be about money, and I'm not saying you can't do ASMR for money, but I just feel like that's not what ASMR is supposed to be about, you know? My dog is so gassy tonight. I don't know if you guys, like, I don't know if the mic was picking up on his stomach rumbling, but he has been farting and his stomach is rumbling so loud. Yeah.
Why I choose to remain non-denominational.
is not something that I choose to associate with for many reasons. I don't think there's anything wrong with it if that's what you want to do. But I just think that, unfortunately, a lot of the times people weaponize the Bible and they weaponize God to scare people into, you know, behaving a certain way or, you know, living their life the way that they think they should be living it. And, you know, it's sad because that's not what it's supposed to be like. But I always try to be self-aware and make sure that I am not contributing to the problem, because I don't ever want to make people feel like they have to be afraid of God or like, you know, that they can't talk to him or anything like that. You know, when people, like, yes, the Bible does say fear God, but it means fear God, like respect God, and people take fear God and turn it into something very ugly. And, you know, fear is what makes us turn away from something, right? And if God wants us to go to him, he's not going to want us to be afraid of him, because fear causes people to turn away from what they're afraid of. So that wouldn't make sense. You know, it wouldn't make sense for God to want us to genuinely be afraid of him. You're supposed to, you know, fear God in the sense that you know that he is all-powerful and he's in control, you know, and you can't go around and be a horrible person and expect there to not be repercussions. But you're not supposed to be afraid of God, like he's going to harm you or like he's an evil being, you know what I mean? And, yeah, I mean, if I'm not someone who tries to, like, push my faith onto other people, if you respect my beliefs, I'll respect yours. I think that, unfortunately, we do live in a society where, you know, people are a bit too okay with mocking God and disrespecting Christianity. I don't have a problem with people, like, calling out church issues and all that, but when you're actually mocking God, and you're going as far as, like, mocking Jesus' death and all of that, like, that is not okay. That's just not okay, you know, because as much as Jesus was God, he was also human at one point, and he, you know, was genuinely tortured, and that's not something to make fun of, you know. If you wouldn't make fun of that happening to, you know, just, if you wouldn't make fun of that happening to a person, then you shouldn't make fun of that happening to Jesus, because like I said, he was once human too. Let this serve as a reminder that